Basically Computers by Madison. The Jacquard machine was created in 1804 by Joseph Marie Jacquard in France, and it was the first machine to use interchangeable punch cards to instruct a machine to perform automated tasks. In the year 1837, the first mechanical computer called the analytical engine was built by Charles Babbage and was programmed by Ada Lovelace. In the year 1890, at MIT, Hermann Hollerith created the tabulating machine. The tabulating machine was designed to help the U.S. government with its 1890 census. In 1937, John Vincent Atanasoff and his student Clifford Berry built the first electronic digital computer. In 1983, the first programmable computer, called the Z1, was created by Konrad Zuse in Berlin, Germany. The Colossus Mark I was the first electric programmable computer and the first large-scale use of vacuum tubes. Vacuum tubes would switch thousands of times per second. This was the basis of radio and long-distance telephone. On February 15, 1946, John Mauchly and J. Pesper Eckert at the University of Pennsylvania, United States, created the first general-purpose programmable electronic computer. This was faster than any machine that came before it, and it was operational for 10 years. On September 9th, 1947, the Harvard team working on Mark II calculator found a moth trapped in the relays of the computer. Chris Hopper wrote, "First actual case of a bug being found." On December 16, 1947, John Bardeen, Walter Britton, and William Shockley on Murray Hill, New Jersey, created the first transistor. 1952, John Mauchly and J. Presper Eckert in the United States were able to create the first computer to predict election results called UNIVAC. It predicted that Eisenhower would win the election.
Why computers use the binary system? What is binary? Binary, as you can see with bi, is anything with two outcomes. What is a bit? A bit is short for binary digit. It can either be a 1 or a 0, also known as the on and off of the whole or no whole. It is the most basic unit of information. It takes more digits to write in binary than the decimal system. Computers use bits because it is much easier, cheaper, and more reliable to code with computers that only have two inputs. What is a computer? It is input, storage, processing, and output. Computer science is literally just the study of computers. A protocol is a set of rules governing the exchange or transmission of data between devices. In this, I will be explaining how to transfer binary into decimal and decimal into binary. When transferring binary into decimal, you always have to look at the first digit. This is going to decide whether the number is odd or even. Another important thing to note is that whether a number is 0 or 1 shows if it's off or on. Every digit follows a system of 2 to the n, pushing every placeholder. 2 to the 0, 2 to the first, 2 to the second, 2 to the third, and 2 to the fourth. This is off, right? So it's going to be an even number. There is going to be no 1. This is on. There is going to be a 2. This is on again, so there is going to be a 4. Off. And there isn't going to be an 8. On, so there is going to be a 16. Adding these together, you get 22. Decimal into binary. How many bits are we going to need to be able to fit for 14? It will fit into 2 to the 4th because the highest number you can do is 15. Highest decimal number you can make with n bits is 2 to the n minus 1. 2 to the 4th minus 1 is 15. Obviously, 14 fits into this. We know because we had to use 4 bits that we're going to have a 1 in the first place. 14 is even, so there's going to be a 0 in the first place. 2 to 0, 2 to the 1st, 2 to the 2nd, and 2 to the 3rd. We know that we have an 8, and we have a plus 0 over here. We're missing 6, so we need a 1 and a 1. We have 14. To be able to use binary, one has to use ASCII, or American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Below my ASCII, it is going to be in 8 bits or a byte. Let's start out with our first one, which is 01001, and then the rest are 0. It is capital H, so we'll write a capital H here. There is a difference between a lowercase h and a capital H. 01101. And that is going to be somewhere here, and it is I. Once you get the hang of it, you can just quickly look at the reference sheet and find the character you are looking for. There's going to be two L's, and it's hi, y'all.